care about who she know. I got secrets and I can keep it, I think you should know. 5'5", and she too fine. I got options.
Hey y'all, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, welcome to my channel. It's your girl Shania Lachelle, and I am back with another video. Period. But this video was highly requested, so I'm finally gonna do it. So let's get straight into this video. Okay, so let's get started. Let me start screen recording so y'all can see. I have not done a what's on my iPhone in forever. So make sure y'all go check out my first what's on my iPhone. I think it was my 11 Pro because I've got a 12 now. I have not had a new phone since my 12 mini. So yeah, let's start off. This is my lock screen. As you can see, I have a reminder. This is my reminder. It reminds me every day at 12 p.m. focus on yourself and go get that bag. And I'm gonna tell y'all that, ladies. Focus on yourself and go get that bag, because that's the most important thing. So that is my reminder. Yeah. This is my lock screen. I made it as like my vision board. When I was making my vision board for 2022, I have one on my computer too, so I decided to make one for my phone as well. So it's my lock screen. And this is my home. Of course, everybody has widgets now. So yeah, I actually, funny story, y'all, I have not like really changed my widgets since like maybe summer of last year. I was really bored and I was looking for like widgets and stuff, like on Pinterest, like ideas and stuff. So I have not changed it, and I probably want to change it at the beginning of summer, which is coming up soon. So I'm probably gonna change it, but I like simple stuff, so that's why mine is kind of simple. And the funny story is, I actually paid like 50 cents for this, for like only certain stuff. Like some of the pictures are actually my pictures, but 50 cents for like the apps on Etsy. So yeah, I just really like the color. The background I actually got from Google. So yeah, all my apps is on my, I removed it from my home screen, but we're not worried about that. So of course I have the calendar up here. I feel like that's the most important thing. You go girl. I just like the background and it's simple, it's cute. I like the color, chill. So these are the main apps that I use on my phone, like my daily apps. So it's of course the phone, the call, and they're all connected to like shortcuts. So like as soon as I press it, it's gonna come up for whatever app I'm going into. I have my messages, my pics, Instagram, of course. That's all in that little, the top right corner and down in the left corner on the, below. I'm sorry, y'all, I can't talk. I have Snapchat, music, Twitter, and TikTok. And all of those, all of these apps on my main page, on the first page, are my favorite apps. Like, I use these daily. It's not a day that I don't use these, especially TikTok, y'all. I love TikTok. But the next screen is You The One with the money sign. I actually got that picture from Pinterest. And in the middle, it says she is clothed with strength and dignity, and she laughs about future. Proverbs 31:25. That is in my Instagram bio. That's one of my favorite Bible verses. So I have that just to like keep me motivated, you know, like little affirmations and stuff like that you need. Good vibes only. I got that from Pinterest as well, and it kind of like matches my color theme. So I try to keep the like color theme, you know, simple but like match. So these are some more apps that I use. I don't technically use them every day, but I kind of do. Well, not Facebook, but yeah. I get Facebook point of time, but I just like how it looks. So email, Facebook, Blackboard. For all my students, Blackboard, I have to have that on one of my main pages. YouTube, Safari, Pinterest. Pinterest is one of my favorite apps. It's so relaxing. I don't know. It's just something about Pinterest and TikTok. I don't, it just gets me. And then the clock and then the weather. So like so many little utilities, whatever. And then on the last screen, I just have my job up there because I hate when it's not on like my lock screen or whatever. Well, not on my like home screen. So I have to keep it on the side because it gets me notifications from them. So on the bottom, I have like little stuff that I have been removed from my home screen. So I just put it on the bottom. It's not in no particular order or like in anything. It's just here. I don't know why I just put these here. So I have my calendar, my camera, maps, the clock and the weather app, wallet, no, Apple Wallet, because I use Apple Pay, notes, and of course the reminders, because reminders, I have like a agenda, but I really like use reminders more than my agenda. Then I have the Apple Store, Health, I don't know why I never deleted that, Safari, of course, FaceTime, Calculator, Settings, next screen is Voice Memos, Find My iPhone because I do have my friends' locations and yeah, I be seeing where y'all at, so. But anyways, Files, Apple Store, and Watch, my Apple Watch, of course, the app. I really don't even know the difference between the App Store and then the Apple Store. Well, I guess it's Apple products and like Apple stuff and then, you know, like games and stuff on the App Store. So I don't even know why I said that. That was just whatever. So on the next little thing on the bottom, I don't know what y'all call those, like dots, whatever, I don't know. I have Spinrilla. That's a music app where I have like old music on Spinrilla that I use that's not like on Apple Music. So yes, I still use Spinrilla, but not as much. The fitness app, Bible app. Y'all can tell I haven't been using my Bible app in a while because I need to update it. And then I have like my banking stuff. So my banks and like check my credit score because I am 20 years old. I do have credit and I want to make sure my credit is good. So Flow is a period app for my ladies. It tells you everything. So I highly recommend getting that. If you are a female out here, get the Flow app. Best thing ever. PayPal, Facebook, Discover. I don't know why Tropical Smoothie is right here. And then the Facebook Messenger app. Let me tell y'all, it's so many notifications on Facebook because I do not get on Facebook at all. It's just like an app where I like use to contact my family and all that stuff, you know. But I just don't use Facebook. Nothing wrong with it. It's just Shania LaShow does not use Facebook. So get on it every once in a blue moon. But on to the stuff that I removed my home screen. So you see my suggestions and my recently added. Okay, so these are all the social app, my social media apps. Facebook, FaceTime, Insta followers, because y'all are not famous. I do not follow people that don't follow me. I'm sorry. That's just me. Nothing's wrong with it. No beef, nothing. I just don't do that. So GroupMe, because I do have GroupMe to talk to like my classmates and my classes and stuff like that. Artists at Instagram, Messengers. The reason why I only have a lot of messages is because I'm in group chats and I don't really like group chats, to be honest with y'all. I put them on mute. So I check them every once in a while, but my messages have like saved from like previous phones too, so that's why I really have a lot. I text the same three people every day, so don't think that my phone is popping because my phone is dry for real. And then the rest of the apps y'all already see. I barely use Snapchat for real. I just get on it just to like get on it, you know. Snapchat is kind of like died down now. But utilities, of course. Event ticket, I had that for Erica's store when I was working there. Sub count to see my sub count for my subscribers. Let's see where we at. Yes, Piriana. So yeah, Voice Memo app watch, and then the YouTube tracker. I've recently downloaded that app because I've been seeing a lot of people post it and they seem to really like it. So I actually really rock with it. It's a really cool app, whatever. And on that app, you get to see like your subscriber count. It's kind of like YouTube Studios, but like you get to see like your watch out, like you get to see everything on it too. Same as YouTube Studios. So productivity, of course, my job is the first one. Calendar, Dasher, because I used to DoorDash sometimes. I haven't recently DoorDashed in a long time, maybe since last year. But I definitely did. I never deleted it. Google Docs, Gmail, because I have Gmail for like my, that's my school email stuff. But like my regular email is my mail, of course. Notes, Outlook is also something for school, my school email. Shortcuts, of course, to like have my widgets and stuff. Square Team is the app that I used to clock in at Erica's when I used to work there. I never deleted it, so. Zoom, and then Widgetsmith. Widgetsmith is, you know, where you create your widgets. If you want to create widgets and just YouTube how to create widgets, it is a very long process. I can say when I was creating my widgets and stuff and doing, like, creating my phone, it did take me like an hour. No joke. It takes time. So when you are creating your widgets and stuff, just know that it takes a lot of time. But now we're into entertainment, and this is just stuff that I watch. So this is what I mean when people be tweeting, like, I feel them. Y'all cannot talk to me any kind of way. You cannot treat me regular because I got everything. Disney, Hulu, Paramount, Showtime, HBO Max, like everything. But yeah, no, for real. So I got Disney Plus, ESPN, and Hulu, only because like that's the three subscriptions. So if you want to like, I think it's like $12 just for those three. So yeah, Eventbrite is for like, you know, tickets and stuff, where you buy tickets. I go to parties, y'all. I do. I'm a homebody sometimes, but I do go to parties, and that's where most of the party tickets you purchase. HBO Max, self-explanatory. I love HBO Max. Music is like YouTube, but I downloaded to listen to like music, so I won't have to, that's not on Apple Music, and you can like X out the app and like do regular stuff on your phone. So that's why I have music. The music app, of course. Netflix, Paramount Plus. I really rock to Paramount Plus. I really used to watch it because when I was in Alabama, I would watch SpongeBob because I had a Roku TV, so I didn't really have cable. So I will watch old episodes of SpongeBob and stuff. I really don't use it. Showtime, I need to update it. As y'all can see, I haven't used Showtime in a while. I only have Showtime to watch The Chi, and the new season is about to come out. So I'm so excited about that. I already talked about Spinrilla. Stars app, because Stars is it too. With Power, like Tommy. Like, black people only call it Tommy. Have you watched Tommy's thing, like Tommy show? But yeah, I love Stars. The CW app, I only use it to watch like episodes of All American. I recently only downloaded the CW app because I was watching the new All American Homecoming. 10 out of 10, y'all. I highly recommend it. Best show, like I really love that. I haven't caught up on a new season of All American. I'm waiting for it to come on Netflix because I'm so behind. So yeah, but All American Homecoming, it just recently started, so y'all should check it out. I really highly recommend it. It's so good. TNT, because I do be watching the basketball games. It's playoff season and most of the games be on TNT. So yes, I do love sports, so definitely. Tubi is a free movie app, and it has like older movies. Like, it has all the good older movies. I'm not even gonna lie to y'all. I watch Tubi when I be really, really bored in the house, not doing nothing, and I want to watch a movie. Like, I'm like, oh, let me watch an old movie from back in the day, you know, I used to watch. Has all the movies. It has even like good little, like, you know, low cut movies. I'm telling y'all, Tubi, don't sleep on Tubi. Tubi is where it's at. And then of course YouTube. Photo and video, of course the camera. The eraser app. I use the eraser apps to like download like PNGs and stuff and like erase the background and stuff. Of course I have iMovie up here, self-explanatory. I do sometimes edit on my phone when I'm not around my computer and I want to edit something. But yeah, that's why I have iMovie up here. Fonto. I use Fonto to make my thumbnails. I also use the Studio app. I recently started using it because when I bought Nyla's editing thing, she talked about how like Studio is also a good app to use for making your thumbnails, and it actually really good. It's really good. Like, it already has like the edits and stuff. Well, not the edits, but like the coordinates and stuff that you need for the to make your thumbnail and stuff like that. It even has like your channel banner. But I mostly use Fonto. Visco. I haven't used Visco in a while, but it's a photo editing app. It has different filters and stuff, but the most popular filters you have to buy, so that's why I don't use Visco like that anymore, and I rarely edit my pictures. So PhotoGrid, self-explanatory. Use it when you like want to make your pictures and collages and stuff like that, make it smaller, whatever, photos. And YouTube Studio is like YouTube trackers, which I talked about in the beginning. You get to see your subscriber count, your watch hours, how good your video is doing, like your analytics and all that stuff. And my other app, the Bible app. Happy Lighting is my Bluetooth app for my LED lights that's in my room on my bed. So yeah, I just use it because I don't know where the remote is, so I'm glad that it's like I can use my phone to connect it. The Latch app, that's like for to unlock my apartment, blah blah blah. I'm not gonna talk about that. Pinterest, whether you already know that. And then I deleted most of my games on my phone because I rarely play games on my phone, but I did buy Monopoly and I did buy Papa's Wingeria because that's my favorite out of the Papa's theme. I don't know why I like the expensive apps, y'all. The expensive games. But I definitely did buy Monopoly, and I definitely did buy Papa's Pop, Wingavria, whatever. So, and then I have Trivia Crack too. Just to keep my brain going sometimes. I really like Trivia Crack. Like, it's kind of, it's low-key addicting. So, travel, Airbnb, BP Me is a like gas station app where like, when you use the app and you like create an account, you can get like cents off your gas if you go to a BP. Google Maps, self-explanatory. Uber, because I don't use Uber, but I used to use Uber. I never deleted it. So, in the Waze app, I highly recommend the Waze app. I just got put on to the Waze app. But it tells you where the police is. It tells you everything. Like, it tells you if it's something on the corner, like a car on the corner of the road. Like, it tells you everything. But finances, I feel like that's self-explanatory. I feel like everybody has Cash App. Those are my bankings and, you know, stuff to check my credit. Venmo is also like a Cash App. Yeah. I don't really use Venmo anymore, though. Shopping and food, y'all. We almost done. Almost done. Okay, Apple Store. Okay, Chick-fil-A. I love me some Chick-fil-A, but I haven't had Chick-fil-A in a while. Like, Chick-fil-A don't hit the same to me. But let's see where my points at, y'all. Because I know I don't have none. 882. Because I've been using my points when I go to Chick-fil-A. I need to start saving them. So, Fashion Nova. These are the most stored. Like, the stuff that I have up here is the stores that I shop from. So Fashion Nova, I really don't shop from Fashion Nova, but I shop from them from time to time. Klarna, McDonald's, because y'all be sleep on McDonald's. I don't know why y'all be trying to fake on McDonald's, but McDonald's is, it be hit sometimes. Nike, Pretty Little Thing, Shein, Smoothie King, Starbucks, Target, and Tropical Smoothie. And I feel like those are just self-explanatory. They're like shopping, food, stuff. So education, Blackboard, of course, Mathway and PhotoMath. I haven't used those in a while because I haven't had a math class. Like, I took math my freshman year, so I just still have it up here. Quizlet, of course, and Socratic will save your life. Not only will Quizlet save your life, but Socratic too. Socratic. And then these are the last things. Well, this is like the last app. Will it even let me go to this morning? Oh, because I only have 4 apps in it. So it's the Flow app, you know, what I recommended for my ladies. Fitness app, and I guess, I don't know what this is. Oh, the health and activity app. I don't use that. And then this last app on the bottom right is the birth control app. It lets you, it has like every birth control, like it'll let you put your birth control in and it'll remind you to like when you take your birth control or when you start a new packet. So I really like that. I just be forgetting to log in sometimes. So yeah, so that is the end of this video. I told y'all I really wasn't nothing interested on my phone, but I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Don't forget to give it a thumbs up and stay tuned for my next video, you guys. I'm trying to be consistent, so I will see y'all in my next video. Love y'all.